Hello, my name is Calvin DeVries and I specialize in the 4-H Youth Development Program for Nebraska Extension in Lancaster County. And today I'm going to talk with you about embryology. So some of you may have heard the ending of this word in your science class, the ending being ology. You may have heard the term biology, geology, or something like that, but the term biology is the study of life. And we're going to further break it down and study embryos. So an embryo is the very first stage of life. So all plants, animals, cats and dogs, myself and you as the viewers, start out their life as an embryo. And the ending here, ology, means the study of. So we're going to be studying embryos. And to do this, we're going to place fertilized eggs in an incubator to have you view the 21-day developmental process of a chicken embryo. So these eggs are special, and they come from a farm that have both hens and roosters, so they are going to be fertilized. The rooster being the male and the hen being the female. So on those farms, those eggs are fertilized. And when placed in the incubator, in 21 short days, we will have chicks hatching live. But to get to this point of an actual hatch, there are three really important things we need to do caring for the eggs in the incubator. The first being monitoring the temperature by using a thermometer, placing it on the inside. And we're going to do the best we can to keep it at a perfect 100 degrees. That is due to the fact if the mother hen were to be sitting on the eggs on the farm, that's her natural body temperature. So if she were to be sitting on them on the farm, she would fluff up her feathers and sit on multiple eggs at one time. But while utilizing the incubator, we're going to monitor daily by checking our incubator, making sure our incubator is reaching 100 degrees. Now, the second most important thing is turning the eggs. So we need to turn the eggs as that embryo is not strong enough to turn itself on the inside of that egg on its own until day 18. So if you view live on the 4-H egg cam, we will have automatic turners that will look yellow that will be naturally turning it 3 times a day. But if we were to do it live in a classroom, we would be turning them by our hands. So we'd place an X on the side of the shell to help us monitor how many times a day and which direction we were flipping those eggs by placing the X up and the X down 3 times throughout that cycle in the classroom. But if the mother hen were to doing it on the farm, it would be her natural instinct, so she would be born knowing how to do that 3 times a day. But since she doesn't have the luxury of hands, she'd be utilizing her beak and her toes. So she'll naturally turn them 3 times a day. But we also need to monitor humidity levels in our incubator. And that is due to the fact that moisture or humidity in the air is required for those embryos to develop and develop correctly. So if we were to hold an egg, we would recognize that there's really tiny holes or pores all over the eggshell. Now to compare to our skin has pores as well. So in the winter months, when our skin gets dried and cracked, we add lotion to them. And then they look soft and healthy again. So now if we go back to our incubator, when we add water at 100 degrees, it'll evaporate to create humidity. And that humidity will enter and exit the pores of the eggshell, just like lotion would do, moisturizing our hands. So while that water is entering the shell, it's keeping the very first layer on the inside, or the shell membrane, nice and soft, which will make it really easy for when that embryo or that chick gets ready to hatch on day 21. Now, if we go back to the example where we put lotion on our hands to moisturize our skin, if we weren't to put water in our incubator, that shell membrane would be very hard, and it would be hard for that chick to hatch on day 21. Okay, so now let's talk about what's going on the inside of our eggs today. So on the inside of our egg, at the very top, or the larger end of the egg, we find the air cell. And so when that chick gets ready to hatch on day 21, it'll peck all the way around the top of that air cell in a perfect circle, taking its first breath and then piercing through the shell, exiting on day 21. And if we move in a little bit further, remember our example that we're creating humidity in our incubator. This is that shell membrane that we're keeping really nice and soft for when that chick gets ready to hatch. If we move a little bit further in, we find the albumen or the egg white. The egg white scientific name is the albumen. If we move a little further in, we have the yolk. That'll be that really big round yellow circle on the inside of our egg. And to keep everything in place, we have what we call chalazae, providing the egg structure just like bones do in our body. So if we were to be turning them, we would need to be really careful handling them, not to shake or drop them, because that could disrupt those chalazae. But our eggs, remember, are special. So they have a certain structure called the germinal disc or germ spot. So that is going to be where the embryo begins to develop, absorbing the yolk and albumen as its source of nutrition, essentially the food and water as it grows and develops. But if we were not to have eggs that came from a farm that have hens and roosters and just bought them from the grocery store, they would never hatch because they would be without a germinal disc or germ spot, so they would have came from a farm that just have hens. Now, we'll place eggs in the incubator for you to watch hatch live at the 4-H egg cam. Thank you.